my background is I grew up, was born in the 30s. I grew up in the 30s and 40s in a section in Brooklyn called Brownsville, East New York, which is a very poor, was a ghetto neighborhood. And things were, you know, very rough for everybody. And it's in that context that I want to speak about the impact that Leslie had. And growing up in that period, it was, as I say, a refugee. Most of the people, many of the people rather, who were living in the area were immigrants. It was a small black population. It was a neighborhood that had big gangs. They had, for example, at that time, something called Murder Incorporated, which was a Jewish mafia. They had a street gang called the Amboy Dukes, where, you know, everybody used to know how to duke. And you had to know to be able to walk in the street, you know, and stuff like that. And that's what the neighborhood was like. And it gave rise to a guy called Lazar. And he was a guy who had just come out of jail. And he was in jail because he was, you know, when you get poor, these things happen. He became an enforcer for the mob. And then when he finished time, he came out, you know, and he was gay. And I remember one time, he was hanging out at the same, he hung out at the same candy store, same block that I did. We knew each other, blah, blah, blah. So at any rate, he was leaving. He was to go home, and, you know, he made some, you know, remarks about, you know, let's get together, blah. At any rate, he also had a drinking problem. So he went to the, he went to a bar where he used to drink, you know, beer, and he had done time, and he had some guys, it was a tough bar, it was a very bad bar, the neighborhood had a rough reputation, and he got into a thing with somebody. He broke a beer bottle and took the guy's eye out. And then he went, spent the rest of his life in jail doing time because, you know, of this crime. And for me, having that happen to him and see what happened to his life, it was, being gay was a very difficult thing. I mean, made life much more difficult. And then when my son turned 18, he told me that he was gay and he was going to come out and be gay, you know, live the life of a gay person. And I remember, well, just a second, and I remember when he told me that for me it was yet another problem, so to speak, in life. We went through tremendous poverty in the 30s, tremendous anti-Semitism, and now this was another, you know, pain to bear. And it was the way Leslie led her life that helped me understand and gave me was very, you know, positive and beneficial to let me understand that you could live that life and be perfectly fulfilled. It doesn't have to be a life that leads to crisis. So when I thought of Laser, that's what I thought about. You go to the bar, you get a drink, you get into a fight, you know, you wind up in the hospital. And so I just wanted to say that Leslie's life and her accomplishments was very positive in helping, you know, understand. Thank you.